We have a lot of things we want to share with you today and cover, and it should be an incredible time for us together with you all. So I just want to mention that God looks at us and has created us to be whole people. He didn't create us to be little parts. He didn't create us to be a mind or a physical body or our thoughts or feelings. We're a whole to God. And so part of being healthy means that our whole self is healthy. It's not that God created us so you can have a healthy body and be totally broken and depressed and miserable and anxious and sad. And He didn't create us to have a healthy mind and a broken body where you're joyful and happy and at peace in your life, but your body's completely broken. It just doesn't work that way. One affects the other. We need to be whole in both our mind and our body. Otherwise, you're not gonna be the way you want to be. You're not gonna have the kind of life that you want. So one of the things that I love about the word, about the scripture, is how much God reinforces that. He reinforces His love for us. He reinforces how important He thinks a healthy mind is. Healthy thoughts, healthy feelings. Remember all the beautiful things in the word. You know, love the Lord thy God. Love thy neighbor as thyself. All of the Philippians 4:8 beautiful words where God wants us to focus on His word, His thoughts. John 15, conform your mind to me. Look at all the beautiful things that God says. And then He answers all of our prayers, everything that He wants. So that's a precious thing. And so is having physical health. What does He say in Corinthians? That we are the temple of the Holy Spirit. You know, the Holy Spirit dwells within us. And we need to have healthy bones, healthy heart. There's different things God mentions in the Word in terms of even our physical health. He wants us to eat good food. He wants us to exercise. So there's so much in the Word that reinforces why a healthy mind and healthy body together are really important. So we're going to be covering both of these things today and really excited to be doing this with all of you. We really encourage you to send us the issues that you're dealing with. If you have any illnesses, mental, physical, emotional, life issues, please send them to us because we'd love to cover them during our time with you. One of the things that I wanted to start with, because there's so much, is that as I do ministry and in all the time that I've been a medical doctor, people come to me with the things that not only they feel physically impaired with and have symptoms and they don't feel good, but a lot of mental and emotional things come up. It's amazing how many of these things there are. It's just incredible. For example, one of the big things that I hear about all the time from people is lack of self-confidence in things that they do. You wouldn't think this would be true. You'd think, oh, everybody's so full of feeling great about themselves, and if you're worried or you lack self-esteem or self-confidence, you're going to think it's just you, and that everybody's around you is just full of feeling great and feeling confidence, and they're all peak performers. And it's not the way it is. When you really work with people as a minister like I am, or as a medical doctor like I am, what you learn is that people really can lack that in different areas. Everybody's so different. Some people may lack self-esteem in being able to have the career they want. They may not feel like they're worthy, or they can have the things that they want to do in their work. They feel like they never get what they want. They either don't get the job they want, or they don't get the promotions once they're in it, and everything is less than. And even the wealthiest, most successful people, they're in competition with each other. So you could be a multi-billionaire and feel like you're less than another billionaire. It's really funny how the enemy works, because this is all from the enemy. This isn't from God. God loves you and He uplifts you and He wants you to feel really good about yourself. So only the enemy would take a multi-billionaire and make the multi-billionaire feel really lacking and not good enough because you're not as big as the other billionaire. So, or a super athlete who's not as good as another athlete. So everything's sort of that competition feeling. So this is not God's plan for any of us. And what's incredible is that we have many chemicals in our body that not only regulate from God how our bodies work, but how we feel and how we regard ourselves. So I wanted to pray into that first of all as we start, because these are very issues for people. It's what keeps them lacking, whether it's in your work or whether you feel like you're not good at relationships or you're not good at sharing or showing your heart, or you don't trust people, or you feel you've been hurt and wounded, and you just, you know, don't have the self-confidence or the self-esteem to just open your heart wide and huge, which is what God wants. His first commandment, love the Lord thy God and love thy neighbor as thyself. Number one and number two, top commandments of God. Or you don't feel good enough in your income capacity, or you don't think your house is nice enough. It's just endless. You feel like your kids or your family's ashamed of you. I mean, it goes on and on and on. So I want to do a little bit of work with you on this, because this isn't God's feelings. You are precious to God, and he thinks you're the most precious thing that ever lived, because we're all his children, and we know from the word what God thinks about children. He loves them. What did Jesus say in the Bible? Don't even touch a hair on this child's head. They were precious to him. He blessed children. He would put his arms around them. He would put his hand on them and bless them. He said nobody should ever do anything that would harm a child. And we are God's children. Doesn't matter how special or how big a deal your life is. To God, we're just little children. A lot of the chemicals that God created that do work on our body work on our mind. So what are some of his incredible chemicals? Because we all have them. And I want you to kind of tune into the chemicals that maybe you need to focus on a little bit more to be blessed by God and realize how much you're blessed. So let's take a chemical like serotonin. So serotonin is a chemical that in the medical field we call inhibitory. It's a chemical that calms your mind, calms your body, helps you sleep, helps you relax, affects your appetite and how hungry you are for food. So it's a beautiful chemical, and it does a lot of good things. In women, it helps to regulate menstrual cycle, helps to get rid of PMS symptoms. There's a lot of things serotonin does that are really good. That's in the physical world. But how many of you know that serotonin was created by God to build your self-confidence and self-esteem? It's one of the reasons we need all of these chemicals that we call neurotransmitters, or neuropeptides, or neuroendocrine hormones. These are things that are all over our brain. And we need all of them because they all not only build us up physically, but they build us up mentally in how we feel about ourselves and everybody around us. So serotonin is amazing because when you have plenty of serotonin and it's in great balance, you have a lot of self-confidence and self-esteem. And it's not bad self-esteem. It doesn't mean you're an ego or you're full of yourself. It means that you really understand how much God loves you and how precious you are to the Lord, and that you are a precious child, and that as God's child, he doesn't want us to think anything less of ourselves because he created us. He wants you to love yourself. He wants you to love others. He wants you to do both. So again, self-esteem and self-confidence, serotonin. There's a chemical on the other side, which is the excitatory side, that kind of revs you up. Serotonin kind of quiets you down. But the excitatory chemicals kind of give you energy and rev you up. And there's a chemical on that side called dopamine. And that chemical is very different from the serotonin, which gives you the confidence and self-esteem. The dopamine and also another chemical called glutamate give you joy. And they give you positivity, and they reward you. Literally, they bring reward and joy and happiness into your life. So we need both. They both complement one another. You want to have joy and happiness and be rewarded in your life with all the good things. And then you want to have the self-confidence and the self-esteem so you feel you deserve it. It can have these things come in. And the two together are amazing. They actually complement one another. And they need to both be at the right levels and to work together and to complement one another. We need our dopamine for our joy and our rewards and our happiness. And we need our serotonin for our self-esteem and self-confidence. So I'm going to just take a minute and pray into this for you, because it's very important, because these things first come from God, and secondly, we reinforce it with our own positive thinking, and then having even things like a healthy diet like a diet that's high in serotonin and high in dopamine. And the precursors, the amino acids that make these chemicals that we take in through our diet, part of it's from our diet, part of it's from our own thoughts. It's amazing the way God combines these things. So Lord, I just thank you for these wonderful brothers and sisters in Christ who are with us this afternoon. It's such a joy to be with you all. And we want you to have the very best that God has for you. And that not only means great health, but it means a great mind, mind of Christ. And so I want to pray in the name of the Lord for all of us, all of you who are with us today, that you be absolutely uplifted in the Lord. And those are two chemicals out of many. There's so many I could mention. I might mention a few more today that will build you and will give you the capacity to have the life of your dreams, the life that you desire to have, the life that will make you incredibly happy. So Lord, I want to pray into serotonin and dopamine for my brothers and sisters, that they have the perfect amount, not too much and not too little, but the perfect amount for a healthy mind and healthy body. And so that everything they do attracts love, attracts positivity, attracts the goodness of God to them, not only from the Lord, but from all the people around them. So they're constantly being reinforced by wonderful relationships, everything that's positive, wanting to have a new career or a new job and having the capacity to have it, wanting to make new friends and the friends come in, wanting to have better relationship with a husband or wife or family, and all of these things clear out resentments and negativity and feeling hurt or broken or any of this. Just going away like it never happened, and all you have is the beauty of God's love giving you dopamine, giving you serotonin, giving you strength and energy like dopamine does, giving you all the joy in the world. So you feel like singing and dancing. You feel like going bike riding. You feel like staying out all night and having fun. You feel excited about what you're doing with your work. So you can go ahead and do new projects, be creative, love what you're doing, love the people you're with, and just have an incredible life. And I just want to pray this for all of you, that you are rewarded and that all of those things of the Lord that make you feel good about yourself and the world around you and everybody that you come in contact with is beautiful, is wonderful, and is loving. And I pray this for you no matter where you are in your walk with God, no matter where you are in your relationship with Jesus, that these things just build and build and build, and it reinforces your relationship with the Lord and with everything around you. So you go, wow, my life is amazing. My life is incredible. I can't believe how good it's gotten. It's like every week more and more good things happen to me. So I want to pray that into you, that you have a life that every week more and more good things are happening to you, and all the limitations just start to move out of your life. So I love you guys. It's so wonderful to be with you. It's so wonderful to be with you in the Lord. Bless you all. We love you. Amen.